Welcome Prashant Rajore to the Physics of Pranayama channel. And Prashant is a graduate of the Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay. I don't say Mumbai because IIT Mumbai doesn't compute in my head. It is always Bombay. So he's a graduate of the IIT Bombay, chemical engineer. And right after graduation, he started working under the guidance of Guruji Sri Sri Ravi Shankar in the ashram in Bangalore. And there he has led a diverse array of programs from rural empowerment to construction projects to corporate programs to anything. I mean, he's taught like thousands of people techniques to get established into themselves and find the inner peace. And he's done some incredible work, and we'll find out in due course of this conversation. So welcome, Prashant.
Yeah, thank you, Sandeep.
It's nice to connect after so many years. No?
Yeah, it's almost like 4, 5 years, 5, 6 years now.
Six years. Right.
2014, and I was in US last.
Right, 2014, that's right. That's when we reconnected, but we know each other from way back.
Yeah, from IIT days.
From IIT days, right. So I'd like to start from those days, Prashant, if it's okay with you. So you entered IIT, what, 1992?
Yes.
1992, okay. So describe for us that day where a bright-eyed, bushy-tailed Prashant Rajore walked into the IIT campus and started the journey. So take us back to that day, and how was it for you?
No, it was a mixture of emotions. I very well remember my father came to drop me. I was very excited in being in IIT, and he was there. And when he dropped me to the hostel and he told me bye bye, it was a little emotional also, because that was a time I felt now, okay, now I have to be on my own, manage everything on my own. And there were a couple of tears in his eyes also, and there were a couple of tears in my eyes also. But it was nice. There was a joy that, okay, I'm moving into some into the next chapter of my life. But there was also something that perhaps I'm leaving something back also, you know. So it was a very, very beautiful eye contact I had with him, you know, when he was just leaving. It was the most memorable moment of my life.
Yeah, it's so true. We've all gone through that when we went to the IIT. So tell me, you were a local resident in Mumbai, or did you come from out of the city?
I'm from Pune, so it's about 4 or 5 hours from Mumbai. But still, in those days, distances were large. Even phone calls were very, very expensive compared to today. So it practically meant you were living in some other world.
right. And those days, so when you guys entered 1992, at least there was email on campus, right? So when we entered in 88, we had to write like those inland, those blue letter forms to communicate with parents, etc. You guys had phones or no? You had...
No cell phones. No cell phones, and emails also my parents did not have. So it was that late night STD call to save money, which was at 25% of the day cost. So that was a time to connect. And that would be also once in a week or once in 10 days, 15 days, because saving money was also important.
Yeah, I remember that. Yes. So how was life in the hostel? Like the first few days, did you go through this period called ragging?
Yeah, I would not call it ragging. It was nice. I got to know my seniors. My seniors got to know me. It was a nice exposure to handle a little pressure here and there. I remember a group of seniors, they were asking me about Babri Masjid and Ram Mandir, and it was a very hot issue topic that time. And there were four of them, and if I spoke in favor of the temple, £2 on me, and if I spoke in the favor of something else, the other £2 on me. So learning to handle all that, you know, opposite values and opposite opinions, and yet holding your own, you know, so that you are not pounced upon. So that was a very interesting first 1 or 2 days. I was a little taken aback, but then I said, boss, you have to learn the rules of the game. Otherwise, you cannot survive.
And you were in age 5, right? You were in hostel 5?
Yeah, I was in hostel 5. And it was interesting because as a sportsman, you know, always the thing was, you know, somebody is using some tactic and you have to have an answer with a counter tactic, you know. So that part of me took over and I said, now you have to survive. You can't say I'm in the wrong place or what is this all about?
So
interesting.
What sports did you play? Like you said, you're a sportsman.
I played state level hockey at one moment of time. I was also sent an invitation to represent the state. But in those days, studies always took precedence over sports. If you were good at both. So I chose studies. And then I also played district level football, district level cricket. And I was doing athletics. And these were the four things I would do. But then as side games, I played almost everything. Badminton and table tennis. And I tried my hands at basketball, being a short person also. So yeah. It was fun.
So at IIT, were you in the NSO or the NCC or what? You know, those electives that you
have? I was in NSO and I had applied for all three. My first was hockey, then football and cricket, and I was chosen for all three. And I heard that the coaches of all three were fighting amongst themselves to pull me into their NSO. So in IIT, I felt a little privileged, you know, because being in demand in the first few days was always nice.
Oh, yeah. That's like such a good thing. Yeah. Awesome. So one thing, I was also in H5. And the one thing about Hostel 5 is that it teaches you right from the get-go the value of good food.
Yes.
The Hostel 5 mess is like infamously famous, right?
Yeah, the mess is a mess.
The mess is a mess. Yeah. I jokingly
talk about the mess, you know. For an IITian, the best way to invite him is tell them that it is going to be food and they will drop everything and come. So that training I got in H5.
Yes. Khane ke liye hum kuch bhi kar sakte hain, acche khane ke liye.
Yes. We can travel time zones.
Time zones, yeah, right. So what was your most challenging, let's say, I won't call it ragging, but let's say initiation experience. What was the most challenging thing that you were asked to do? You remember?
There was this senior Viru who was very famous or infamous.
Infamous,
and
yeah.
amongst the freshies, it was like, do whatever, but don't come in the line of Viru, you know, avoid him at all costs. Okay. And for me, after a few days, 2-3 days, it was like, okay, now I have to survive. And somehow, because I was good at sports and everyone was also seeking and searching for me, where is that boy? Oh, you are that boy. Come and meet me after dinner, you know? So I landed up at almost all the seniors' places and everything. So one evening it was him and I went, you know, he took me and he was pressurizing me in a lot of ways. And then he told me, you know, I will give you challenges and if you can satisfy those challenges, I will leave you quickly. Okay. So that was the time our Rajesh Krishnamurti, he's also an Art of Living teacher now. So he entered. So now, Viru told me very challengingly, now you tell me who's the more beautiful of, or more better looking of the two of us. And if you looked at that, there was a huge difference. But, you know, I had to get out very quickly. And I said, rules of the game are rules of the game. It doesn't matter who's who, you know. And Rajesh, I was meeting for the first time. And his first appearance was that he's a very gentle, nice, laughing, loving guy. So, and even you know the difference between the looks and everything. One was fair, the other was dark, you know. So I obviously said there is no choice to choose from. So Viru was a little taken aback. You know, you freshie, you better watch out what you're going to say. So Rajesh was also like very confident that I'm going to talk about him. And I said, yeah, it's Viru. So Viru was like taken aback and he started clapping and laughing. You know, somebody said something like this. And then he said, you know, how will you give it on a scale of 1 to 10? His good looks and my good looks. So I said, I will give Viru 9.5 out on 10. And I will give Rajesh 4 out of 10. So that was the like thing. And what I thought would be a 1 hour affair, it finished in a few minutes because Viru was very happy. Okay, this boy knows what to answer, where to answer. So he left me. And you know, when the Adi freshies saw me walking out so soon, they were like shocked and surprised. Why? What happened? Did he leave you? What? I said, no, everything is well managed.
Nice. Yeah. So you did your chemical engineering, right? At IIT?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes.
So how was that experience of, you know, going from hostel 5 all the way to almost at the exit of the campus to get to chemical engineering department? What was your shortest route? Did you figure it out in the 4 years?
No, for me, it was fun because I was anyway into sports. So it was like running half the distance and walking half the distance if I had time. And age 5, somehow, you know, I would wake up only at 8:15, 8:20. So it was like that 10 minutes to breakfast and then be in class. So, I managed it well and it was exciting. It was like for me an additional exercise, you know, doing exercise every day. So this was like that 1.5 kilometers of extra run in the morning, reaching this. Oh, the only challenge was most of the people in H5 would wear slippers. So yeah. Running on with slip-ons was a little challenging, but it was fun.
Yeah, and did you guys have it? So the initiation to IIT, so how would we know if a person coming to the library is a student or is he a visitor? We could simply look at the footwear. If it's bathroom chappal, it's a student. If it's not.
Yes.
Was it the same for you guys?
Yes. Like I had bought a pair of shoes and I thought, okay, I will use them for 6 months. And after 6 months, another pair of shoes will come. But those pair of shoes lasted the entire stay in IIT. I didn't have to buy it. And for my sports, for my hockey and all that, those sports shoes I had to have. But the other walking shoes and other shoes I didn't buy.
Yeah, we would wear shoes only when we were giving the undergraduate seminar or the BTP presentation. That's the only time you would wear shoes on campus. Otherwise, it's all...
Yes. Yeah.
So what was your BTP? Do you remember what was your BTech project?
My BTech project was heat transfer. Not heat transfer. It was a simulation of a series reactors. It was a simulation on reactors. I forget the name of the reactors now.
Yeah.
Simulation
Who was the advisor? Do you know? Do you remember?
SL Narayan, not SL Narayan, RK Khanna.
Oh, yeah.
RK Khanna.
Cool. So, if you reflect back, now you've got so much more experience. You know, when I watched the movie, have you watched Chichore?
Yes.
Did you like it?
Yes, I liked it. My wife was with me and I told her that this is just a mild representation of what we had.
Yeah.
We went through. The only thing which I didn't like about the movie is they showed H5 as 0 points for a long, long time in the movie. And H5, we were not so zero, you know.
Aray, we were very good at PAF, yeah. We were the king of PAF. H5.
No, PAF also and sports also. Because
sports also, yeah.
Yeah. Because there were... Narya was a basketball player and somebody was... That Khadilkar was a swimmer. And yeah. we had champs in our team and we were not in the top one or two, but three or four, we were there.
Yeah.
But he showed us straight down last, you know, that was... Uh-huh.
But the thing that I liked about Chichori was that he made it real. I mean, those water fights, remember the bucket of water
Yes,
fights? And
yes, yes.
It was so classy. I mean, it just took me back so many years.
Yeah, yeah. It was reliving all those moments, and it was fun. Yeah. Life in IIT was fun, and Chichori was, it had all the cues to take you back to those golden times.
Yeah, yeah. So, the one thing that we have in life now is perspective. We've gone through so many extra years. So when we reflect back, if you had to give like one piece of advice to, let's say, someone aspiring to get into IITs, what would you say to them?
I will say, don't take life too seriously.
Exactly.
If you are good, you will reach. By struggling, even if you get into IIT, getting IITs out of IIT is a circus, and then establishing yourself is also a circus. So if you are good naturally, then you will get into IIT, you will get out of IIT, and even if you don't manage to, you mess up in your entrance exam, you will still find your path. So don't take life too seriously. And 25 years ago, IIT was the thing, but now there are so many institutes, so many opportunities. A lot of students are able to travel abroad also to different countries and study. So it's not worth, you know, having that IIT dream.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Yeah. It has a brand of its own. But if you're good, you're good. Don't take it too seriously otherwise.
Right. So in 1996, you graduated. Chemical engineering was done. And when did you... So between 92 and 96, somewhere you took the Art of Living program?
Yeah, January 1993, in the beginning of my second semester.
Ah, okay. And with Bava or some, with who?
No, Rajshri Patel was my teacher.
Oh, Rajshri, right. But Bava is the guy who organized it?
There was a group of people who organized, and Bava took a few of us along. There was Harish, there was Rajesh, me, six of us from IIT, H5.
Kashi, right? Kashi?
Kashi joined a little later.
Later.
So we were six of us, we were there in that.
Oh, you were in wing four. Okay, now I know which wing it is.